Good day to you all. Let's study about polymerase chain reaction. Polymerase chain reaction, which is one of the very effective procedure for amplifying a small segment of the DNA, used very much in the field of biotechnology, molecular biology. Before to understand polymerase chain reaction, how it is carried out in the biotechnology laboratory, and what are the prerequisites or the components essentially required for the polymerase chain reaction for getting the millions of copies of the small segment of the gene or a small segment of the DNA. Actually, one must be very familiar with DNA cloning technology and as well as the DNA replication technology or the replication process which occur inside the living cell of all the different variety of organisms, namely the plants, animals and other microscopic organisms. Let's take a look about the recombinant DNA technology. Recombinant DNA technology. So recombinant DNA technology, as you know, I think just I would like to give you an idea so that the idea of the knowledge of the recombinant DNA technology and the DNA replication process, DNA replication process helps us to understand what is exactly the polymerase chain reaction. So it is called by the name as a chain reaction. This includes actually the chain of nothing but the series of a sequence of a number of reactions which occur one after the other. So therefore the name chain reaction. So the polymerase chain reaction, in order to understand the polymerase chain reaction, the knowledge of the idea of the recombinant DNA technology, also called gene cloning technology, gene cloning technology, and the DNA replication process is the knowledge. It is very essential. So before to discuss with all of you about in a short way about the DNA replication process, let me to share my ideas regarding the recombinant DNA technology. So recombinant DNA technology discovered in around 1975. It is one of the very effective the technique or the procedure which is used to multiply, or in other words, which is used to generate even the millions of copies of the small segment of the DNA containing the desired gene. This means what? With the help of the recombinant DNA technology, it is possible for us to get millions and billions of the segment of the DNA, a single segment of the DNA, or in other words, the clones of the small gene, number of clones of the small gene. So actually speaking, recombinant DNA technology given a great opportunity for us, not only for getting millions of copies of the small segment of the DNA, but also which is used in different fields, okay, you know something about this, the recombinant DNA technology. The knowledge of the understanding of the gene cloning technology helps us to understand the polymerase chain reaction. So that's why I'm just giving an idea about the recombinant DNA technology, also called a gene cloning technology. So here in the recombinant DNA technology, this technology involves the number of steps. So take for example, in the first step of the gene cloning technology, a small segment of the DNA containing a desired gene, which is isolated and extracted from the foreign organism with the help of the technique known as centrifugation refrigerated centrifugation technique.
So the density gradient refrigeration technique which is used for the isolation and extraction of the desired gene from the choice organism, any of the foreign organism, maybe the plant, animal, or any other microscopic organism. So for getting the desired gene, interested gene, or from any of the foreign organism, actually here the enzyme which is also used, that is restricted endonuclease enzyme. Restricted endonuclease enzymes. Number of restricted endonuclease enzymes are available. So the particular restricted endonuclease enzyme is used to cut and cleave, means what, cut and separate our desired gene, that is an interested gene, from the isolated DNA of the foreign organism in the first step of the recombinant DNA technology. And the second step of the recombinant DNA technology, after getting a desired gene or the particular interesting gene from the isolated DNA of the foreign organism with help of the restricted endonuclease enzyme, and by the process, that is the refrigerated centrifugation technique. Now the second step of the gene cloning technology, here a suitable molecular carrier which is selected. We have to choose and select a particular molecular carrier molecules. So the number of molecular carrier molecules are available nowadays. Out of, say for example, plasmids are there, cosmids are there, phasmids are there, and even the bacteriophages are there. Out of the number of different the molecular carrier molecules, nothing but which are also known as molecular vehicles, also shortly termed as the vectors, which can carry our interested gene, isolated, separated, the interested gene, which is selected in the second step of the gene cloning technology. Plasmids are very commonly used as a molecular vehicles to carry the desired gene later on, which is incorporated into the host cell, and thereby it is cultured, and then after that it is cultured and making of millions of copies. So in the third step of the recombinant DNA technology, after selecting a suitable molecular carrier molecule, actually here in the third step of the DNA cloning technology, gene splicing is carried out. Gene splicing in this the third step of the gene cloning technology, with the help of again a particular restricted endonuclease enzyme, and now the ligase enzyme. So the restricted endonuclease enzymes are always used to cut and cleave a particular the sequence which are present on the double stranded DNA. Ligase enzyme or ligase enzyme, which is used to join the two different segments of the DNA, the two different genes. Ligase enzyme commonly termed as a molecular glue. So with help of the restricted endonuclease enzyme and a ligase enzyme, in the gene splicing, the step of the gene cloning technology, the isolated interested, the desired gene, which is combined together with the suitable molecular carrier molecule, it is termed as a gene splicing. So take for example, this is our the desired gene, this is our interested gene of our interest, the molecular carrier, then the ligase. So we will get the recombinant DNA. So the recombinant DNA
actually contains our desired gene, our the desired gene, recombinant.
Later on, in the next step of the gene cloning technology, this recombinant DNA technology, it is incorporated into the host cell. Incorporation of the recombinant DNA into the host cell, it is the next step of the recombinant DNA technology. So it is usually carried out in such a way that, so the recombinant DNA, say for example, this is a recombinant, the DNA, our desired gene, the DNA containing our desired gene from here to here, okay. Recombinant DNA. This recombinant DNA plus host cells are suspended in a cold calcium chloride solution. The temperature of the cold calcium chloride solution, which is immediately raised to about 42 degrees centigrade. So what happens actually when the temperature of the cold calcium chloride solution containing our recombinant DNA is raised, the small pores will be formed on the cell wall of the host, the bacteria. When the pores are formed, recombinant DNA enter into the particular host cell. So now the transformed host cell containing a recombinant DNA is screened and is separated. This bacterium containing a recombinant DNA, after the screening, the transformed bacterium cells are cultured on the artificially prepared nutrient medium by maintaining a optimum temperature, optimum different the conditions which are required for culturing the bacterium cell in the laboratory. So during the culturing of the bacterium, bacteria multiply. They multiply by multiplying our desired gene. So after the culturing technique, it is possible for us to get a number of new bacterial cells containing our the desired gene. This means that it is possible for us to get a millions of number of the new DNAs, new small segment of the DNA, new genes. It is one of it. So therefore, it is termed as a gene cloning technology. Gene cloning technology. So this recombinant DNA technology helps us to get hundreds and thousands and even millions, even an innumerable number of segment of the DNA. Okay. Other than that particular recombinant DNA technology, let me to discuss with all of you about that another technology. The knowledge of this technology also helps us to understand how exactly the polymerase chain reaction which is carried out in the laboratory. That is the DNA replication process. DNA replication process. You know something, I think, about the DNA replication process. DNA is one and only the biomolecule which is present in all the living cells, have got a special property of the replication. So the DNA replication process takes place in all the living cells, especially during the S phase, during the S phase of the interphase of the cell division, DNA replication takes place. Cell division, replication takes place. So this particular DNA molecule, which is present inside the nucleus, as it contains the two polynucleotide chains, DNA helix containing the two polynucleotide chains, which runs in an anti-parallel manner, in an opposite direction. In an opposite direction. DNA replication takes place in such a way that there are a number of the steps, or in other words, DNA replication process completes in number of different the steps itself. During the DNA replication process, so here just you have to bear in your mind that the cell containing a nucleus and the DNA double helically twisted double stranded DNA molecule which is present inside the nucleus. In the nucleoplasm of the cell, number of different enzymes are present. These enzymes very actively participate in the process of the DNA replication. Other than the number of different enzymes which are present in the nucleoplasm, even in the cytoplasm of the living cell, here all the four different nucleotides are also present. Nucleotides of the DNA molecules are also present, namely adenylic acid, thymidylic acid, guanylic acid, cytidylic acid. These all four nucleotides which are present and are freely suspended in the nucleoplasm of the nucleus, actually they form a pool known as a nucleotide pool. Okay, all these different four nucleotides are also very essentially required for the DNA replication process, and they take part in the process of the DNA replication process. So just you have to bear in your mind the nucleotide pool containing a number of all the four nucleotides, the enzymes, particularly the enzymes like topoisomerase enzyme, helicase enzyme, then RNA primase enzyme, then polymerase 1, 2, 3, etc. More than a dozens of different enzymes participate in the process of the DNA replication process. Out of a number of the enzymes, topoisomerase enzyme, helicase enzyme, take for example, these two enzymes especially participate in the process of the identification of the replication, the origin of the replication which is present on the double-stranded DNA molecule, and as well as this particular enzyme, that is a helicase enzyme, is responsible for unwinding of the double-stranded DNA molecule. So that's why the helicase enzyme is otherwise known as unwindase enzyme. So to begin with, how exactly the DNA replication process occurs in the living cell of all the living beings? So, in the beginning of the DNA replication process, the topoisomerase enzyme especially recognizes the point of the origin of the replication, that is the origin. Double-stranded DNA molecule containing the origin of the replication. So, this particular enzyme along with the helicase enzyme, they recognize the origin of the replication which is present on the double-stranded DNA molecule. So suppose that here it is a replication, the origin of the replication. These two enzymes, the topoisomerase enzyme and the helicase enzyme, they aggregate here, they group here, and these two enzymes become responsible for separation of these two helically twisted the polynucleotide chains. This means that gradually the two polynucleotide chains of the double-stranded DNA, they separate, they unwind with the help of the action, the catalytic action of the topoisomerase enzyme and the helicase enzyme. So the two polynucleotide chains of the double-stranded DNA, they separate. When the hydrogen bonds which are present between the nucleotide sequence of the two polynucleotide chains, they break. When the hydrogen bonds which are present between the two polynucleotide chains, between the nucleotide sequence of the two chains, these two polynucleotide chains separate each other. So these are the free nucleotide chains of the double-stranded DNA. Okay. It is now known as a leading strand. Leading strand. This is now known as a lagging strand. Lagging strand.
Lagging strand.
The third end, the five end, the five end, the third end. Okay. Sequence of the nucleotides. Sequence of the nucleotides. Here are the leading strand of the DNA molecule. There is a continuous synthesis of the new DNA molecule takes place. The synthesis of new DNA molecule on the leading strand of the double-stranded parental DNA takes place always in a 5-3 direction, continuously. On the other hand, in another separated strand, now known as a lagging strand, the synthesis of new DNA molecule takes place discontinuously with the help of the primer molecule. With help of the primer molecule. So the small segment of the RNA act as a primers to initiate the process of the synthesis of the new DNA molecule on the DNA strand, that is a lagging strand of the parental DNA molecule. This continues with the help of the Okazaki fragments, Okazaki fragments, the synthesis of the new DNA takes place on the lagging strand of the separated free strand of the parental DNA during the replication process. So here the action of the polymerase enzyme initiates the process of the addition of the free nucleotides. That means what? The catalytic action of the polymerase enzyme in presence of the small segment of the RNA known as the primer and Okazaki fragments, the chain of the new DNA molecule takes place. Okay, so here for every time in presence of the polymerase the enzyme, all the four nucleotides which are present in the nucleoplasm are added to the, means what, the base pairs with the sequence of the DNA which are present on the lagging strand. It is this, the RNA primer helps for the initiation of the chain, the new DNA molecule, and elongation of the new DNA molecule. Okay, this idea, the knowledge of the DNA replication process, helps us to understand the polymerase chain reaction. That means what? The role of the RNA primer, the role of the polymerase enzyme, and the discontinuous the synthesis of the new DNA template on the lagging strand of the parental DNA molecule, and the nucleotide pool, and the role of different enzymes. So this idea, the knowledge, helps us to understand how exactly the polymerase chain reaction which is carried out in the biotechnology laboratory in order to get the millions of copies of the small segment of the DNA. So here the primer, RNA primer, having a 3-OH end, the 3-OH the end is very essentially required. Then the polymerase enzyme, naturally occurring polymerase enzyme helps for binding the activated polynucleotide molecules to the sequence of the lagging strand of the parental DNA molecule. Just you have to bear this idea in your mind. This idea helps us to understand the polymerase chain reaction. Later on, by comparing the DNA replication process, DNA cloning technology, we can understand how exactly the polymerase chain reaction
operates and how can it gives us millions or billions of the copies within a short period of the time. Because one can get innumerable number of copies of the small segment of the DNA containing the desired gene, nothing but a small the gene, which is possible for us within a very short period of the time. Polymerase chain reaction, it is one such a reaction. It takes a little time for giving millions of copies of the same gene. Millions of copies of the same gene. Let's begin with the polymerase chain reaction. Let us start the polymerase chain reaction. Polymerase chain reaction also very popularly known as people's choice reaction. People's choice reaction. Because, as I already mentioned earlier, polymerase chain reaction, it is one of the very effective procedure for amplifying or for generating a number of millions and even a billions of copies of the small segment of the DNA. This is one of the very easy and as well as very quick process for getting a number of copies of the DNA within the laboratory, that is outside the living cell. So here, let me to discuss what are the components. What are the components required for the polymerase chain reaction? Nothing but prerequisites. What are the prerequisites for the polymerase chain reaction? Polymerase chain reaction came into an existence in around 1985. It was Carrie Mullis who was discovered for the first time the polymerase chain reaction, and later on he was awarded the Nobel Prize for the discovery of the polymerase chain reaction. As he was contributed a lot in the field of the biotechnology, he was one of the scientists discovered the polymerase chain reaction. Because of his contribution, he was awarded the polymerase chain reaction. He was awarded the Nobel Prize. So the nowadays polymerase chain reaction, which is carried out within the laboratory with the help of the thermal cycler, an instrument which is used to carry out the polymerase chain reaction. This particular thermal cycler, an instrument, can be automatically, it's a device or the instrument automatically operate. We can make this particular the thermal cycler automatically run. This particular thermal cycler instrument usually contain a small thin tubes, or in other words a pend of tubes. Small append of tube containing a reaction mixture required for the polymerase chain reaction. Nothing but a thermal cycler, an instrument or the device containing the append of tube, very much essentially required to carry out the polymerase chain reaction in the biological laboratory. Other than this particular, in this the reaction tube or a reaction tube
reaction tube or append of tube of the thermal cycler, the two oligonucleotides are taken. The two oligonucleotides nothing but these are chemically synthesized single stranded DNA oligonucleotides. So in the reaction tube, chemically synthesized single stranded DNA oligonucleotides are taken as a one of the component of the polymerase chain reaction. Okay, so the vast molar excess of the molecules of the two oligonucleotide single stranded DNA oligonucleotides are taken in the reaction tube as a reaction mixture. And another component which is also taken as a reaction mixture in the reaction tube for the polymerization reaction is, that is target DNA sequence of the sample DNA, target sequence of sample DNA. Along with the two oligonucleotides which act as a primers, and a target sequence of the sample DNA, very important component which is used for the polymerase chain reaction as a one of the reaction mixture is TUC DNA polymerase enzyme. After discovering this particular TUC DNA polymerase enzyme, which was revolutionized the biotechnology, this enzyme extracted from Thermus aquaticus bacterium. So it was Thomas Brock who was discovered Thermus aquaticus bacterium in a hot spring of Yellowstone National Park of United States of America. The Thermus aquaticus bacterium lives in the hot springs. This Thermus aquaticus bacterium actually contains the thermostable enzyme known as the TUC DNA polymerase. So it was extracted by a Cetus Institute of USA. Okay, so It was the Thomas Brough discovered the Thermus aquaticus bacterium in the year 1966. Later on, it was the Cetus Institute of USA extracted the thermostable Thuc DNA polymerase enzyme from the Thermus aquaticus the bacterium. This thermostable enzyme, which is used in the polymerase chain reaction as one of the very important the component of the reaction mixture. And then lastly, deoxyribose nucleotides. They all four activated deoxyribose nucleotide triphosphate molecules. Right? Phosphate molecules are required for the polymerase chain reaction. DNA contains the four nucleotides: adenylic acid, guanylic acid, cytidylic acid, and thymidylic acid. All these four nucleotides of the DNA, that is the activated deoxyribose nucleotide triphosphate molecules are used as a one of the components for the polymerase chain reaction. Suppose this is a dependent of tube containing the reaction mixture. This reaction mixture actually contains the two oligonucleotides chemically synthesized. Single stranded deoxy oligonucleotides are used as a primers. So primer 1, primer 2. Vast molar excess of the two primers are actually required for the polymerase chain reaction. These two primers must contain, suppose that the primer molecules, short segments of the DNA containing nucleotides up to a 20 base pair long. Up to a 20 base pair long monomers sequences. Okay. The 5N. They must bear the 3OH. Okay. These two primers are very essentially required, without which we can't carry out the polymerase chain reaction. So we have already taken chemically synthesized deoxy oligonucleotides act as a primers in a append of tube as a one of the component of the reaction mixture. This also contain Thuc DNA polymerase enzyme. Which is a thermostable polymerase enzyme. We have taken the two primers, the polymerase enzyme, which is a thermostable polymerase enzyme, and also the reaction mixture also contains all the four deoxyribose nucleotide triphosphate molecules, and the sequence of DNA target sequence of sample DNA. Reaction mixture also must contain magnesium chloride, potassium chloride, even the buffers. So all these different components used as a reaction mixture to carry out the polymerase chain reaction. So each and every step of each and every cycle of the reaction of the polymerase chain reaction actually contain three steps. One end each cycle of the chain of reactions actually contains three steps. Polymerase chain reaction is a reaction. It contains several sequential chain of the reactions. One end each cycle of the polymerase chain reaction actually contains the three important steps. The first step is the denaturation. And second step is a renaturation. Also, you can call it as an annealing. The third step, which is the synthesis. Or the extension. During the denaturation process, what happens? So in the denaturation step of the one of the cycle of the polymerase chain reaction, as our the reaction mixture contains the double stranded DNA molecule having a sequence DNA, having a targeted DNA. Suppose that this is a double stranded DNA, sample DNA. This sample DNA molecule contains nucleotides, the sequence of the nucleotides. Say for example, our interested the sequence of the DNA may lies from here to here. Nothing but this is the target sequence of the DNA. This is the sample DNA molecule containing a target sequence that this targeted sequence of the DNA that we want to make a number of copies. During the denaturation process, the temperature of the reaction mixture, which is raised up to a 95 degree centigrade. So this high temperature makes the double stranded DNA molecule to unwind. As a result of which, double stranded DNA molecules actually they unwind and then separate. The two polynucleotide chains become free from each other. They separate each other. This is the denaturation process. The step of the every single cycle of the polymerase chain reaction. In the second step of each and every single cycle of the polymerase chain reaction, that is a renaturation. Immediately, the temperature of the reaction mixture, which is cooled down or lower up to a 45 degree centigrade. So already here in the reaction mixture, the two polynucleotide chains are separated. the reaction mixture as it contains separated the two polynucleotide chains and two primer molecules P1 and P2. These two primer molecules, their base pair with a particular sequence of the DNA which are present are separated the strands of the original DNA. Original DNA strands. So during the renaturation process, also termed as annealing, these two primers are added. They pair with a complementary sequences of the DNA, complementary nucleotide sequence of the original DNA strands. They base pair with their complementary, that is, gadolinic acid pairs with thymidinic acid, guanylic acid pairs with the cytidinic acid, like that. So here in the polymerase chain reaction, we have taken the two chemically synthesized deoxyoligonucleotides which act as a primers. These are oligonucleotides, the deoxyoligonucleotides. They pair with a complementary base pairs of the original separated DNA strands, which is now known as a renaturation, also called annealing process. So in the third step of this, every single cycle of the polymerase chain reaction, which is now known as synthesis. So this is one step. You understand the sequence of the nucleotides? Okay, sequence of the nucleotides. Primer 1, primer 2. You can call it as a forward primer, reverse primer. Forward or reverse, like that. Okay. During the synthesis, also called extension of a step of the each cycle of the polymerase chain reaction. One by one, so the reaction mixture also contains all the four deoxyribose nucleotide triphosphate molecules, that is, gadolinic acid, guanylic acid, cytidinic acid, and thymidinic acid. All these activated nucleotides, they base pair with the complementary nucleotide sequences which are present on the original DNA template. Means what? The separated, the two free polynucleotide sequence now act as a template for the synthesis of the new chain of the DNA. The synthesis of the new DNA chain, it initiates and elongates always in a 5-3 direction. Okay? A primer, forward primer, reverse primer. So this particular primer, it initiates and elongates the synthesis of the new strand of DNA. This is a newly synthesized DNA molecule. This is also the newly synthesized molecule. So this is the third step of the single cycle of the polymerase chain reaction. Denaturation, renaturation, and a synthesis. So double-stranded DNA molecule separated, the two primers are added, and the synthesis of the new DNA template takes place. This means that here in each cycle of the polymerase chain reaction, it is possible for us to get a new two copies. Means what? Here in one cycle, from a single copy of the double stranded DNA, we have got the four copies. Means what? It is possible for us to get a two new copies and two already the previous copies. Means what? Two, the four. The same, all the three steps of the polymerase chain reaction of a single cycle repeatedly continued. What happens when all the three steps of the polymerase chain reaction of a single cycle repeatedly occur one after the other? It is possible for us to get the millions of the new copies of the segment of the DNA. So nothing but the polymerase chain reaction. So I can show you here. That means what? The reaction mixture, its components are very important here. The two primers which are used for the polymerase chain reaction also very important. And then the role of the magnesium chloride ions, magnesium chloride and potassium chlorides are also very important. So I can summarize the entire single cycle of the chain of reaction, that is a polymerase chain reaction, double stranded DNA molecule, double stranded DNA molecule, okay, the two separated the new strands of the DNA, okay. Next, here addition of the polymers, here original strand and the new strand. This is the original strand, newly synthesized strand, the original strand and the newly synthesized strand. Okay? Then it is possible for us to get original strand, the new strand, again the original strand, the new strand, original strand, primer, the new strand, the original strand, the primer, the new strand, again the original strand, the new strand, original strand, the new strand, like that. Again, here you may show at another